Race checks with power. Race checks with power. We have all got used to utilizing Zwift Power for checking race results. But can Zwift Power give you more insights? It sure can. You may not have known about the following four functions, but they can be super useful for improving your Zwifting experience. And stick with me, as I will reveal a guide to understanding what these seemingly random numbers mean. Have you ever noticed on your profile page the watt per kilogram or watts metrics having the color orange or blue? Have you checked a month later and realized the colors are different? Well, this is Zwift Power indicating what your rider profile or phenotype is. The color bars represent your best three metrics based on your percentile rank and split by gender, with orange being the best, dark blue being the second best, and light blue third. Are you a powerful, high raw watt rider? Well, then you may have all three colors in the watt section. Maybe you're on the lighter side and your watt per kilograms are your strong suit. Or you could have a combination of the two. Rather than going on gut feel, utilizing these metrics will give you a good indication of how you stack up compared to other riders. Zwift Power isn't only for the post-race. If you click on the home button, then click on an upcoming race you are signed up for, you can see all the riders who are planning to attend. Not only does it provide the start list, but it gives each rider's best 20-minute and 15-second power metrics in both watts per kilogram and raw watts. And you can sort highest to lowest. Do you have a race with a big climb? You can identify the riders who will be your fiercest competition. Additionally, I use it to find other riders a bit better than myself. My 20-minute watt per kilogram max is 4.6 watt per kilogram. Pre-race, I identify a couple riders who are a bit stronger and mark them in my races. This will assist in pushing yourself while avoiding trying to hang onto the wheel of someone much stronger than yourself. You may have noticed a seemingly random result or gain number on the right-hand side of your screen. But what do these actually mean? Well, the result column is used for Zwift Power to calculate your race ranking, which utilizes your best five results of the past 90 days. The better you perform, the lower it will be. But how is this metric calculated? Well, the formula for the calculation is here, meaning your score is based on three variables. One, race quality. Two, finishing position. And three, points per place. Finishing position is self-explanatory, but race quality and points per place require some math to calculate. If you're like me, you're not riding Zwift for a math lesson. So what takeaways do you need to know to improve your race ranking? Well, three key boxes to check include: one, entering races with large field sizes, as it reduces the points per place. Two, having many strong riders in that race, as it increases the race quality. And three, beating individuals ranked higher than you. But why is there sometimes a number under the gain column and sometimes not? That is because the gain simply signifies if your latest result was a top five in the last 90 days. If you see a number under the gain column, it signifies that race was one of your top five races. But you may be asking, I see more than five of these. And that is because each race you improve, the gain number will remain. So if you improve concurrently in six races, all six will remain, because as of that date, it was still an improvement. Simply put, Zwift Power does not retroactively update this gain column. And finally, what does this seemingly random number mean? Well, it is simply the decrease in your average race ranking. Meaning if before the race, your top five scores were 100, 120, 140, 160, and 200 for an average of 144, and your latest race score was 80, then the number for the gain would be 24. If you ever want to check out stats in addition to the default screen, there is this magic button which allows you to do so. It is the columns drop-down button. Think you maxed out a sprint during the last race? Simply toggle the 5-second power. Maybe you just raced the Yorkshire KOF. Not quite a 5-minute effort, but also longer than a minute. Toggle on the 2-minute power view. Bonus tip, if you want to see even more peak power metrics, head over to Zwift Companion App's website. Under My Feed, you can find additional metrics, such as 3-minute, 30-minute power, and even 40-minute power. You can even click on the graph to see almost any time metric you want, and it's available for both raw watts and watts per kilogram. The other key options on Zwift Power include your ranking before the event and rank for the event. Ranking before the event will show the average of your top five races, while rank for the event will show your score that day. If this is one of your top five scores, it means you have improved. Remember these four unknown metrics, and hopefully it will help you improve your Zwift journey.